Welcome to this video. In this video I show you step by step how to install and configure WireGuard Server on Windows. I use a desktop computer as the VPN server and use a laptop as the VPN client. On your desktop computer, go to the WireGuard homepage, download and install the software for Windows computers. You open the software and create configurations for the server and client as follows. I created a new configuration for the server and named it WG Server. Then I created a new client configuration and named it WG Client. You write down the server's public key. Then write down the client's public key. With the configuration on the server, you set it up as follows. You set up the port for the WireGuard application. In this case, I use port 51820. Next, you assign the IP address to the server. I set up IP address 192.168.100.1 for VPN server. Then you set up the client's information. You set up the VPN client's public key. I copy the client's public key prepared from the previous step. The client's IP address is 192.168.100.2, which is different from the server. You save the configuration. Next, you go to configuration for the client. You set the client's IP address to 192.168.100.2, the same as set on the server. Don't forget to set up the DNS address for the client. Here I set the DNS addresses to 8.8.8.8 and 1.1.1.1. Next, you set up the server side. Setting up the server's public key is indispensable. I copy and paste the server's public key. Allow all IP addresses to pass through. You connect to the server using the public address and port 51820. So I have created new configurations for the server and client. Now you export the configuration to a file. Here are the files after being exported and extracted. The client uses a configuration file called WG Client. On the server, you delete the client configuration. By default, the client connects to the server, but it cannot access internal resources. So you share the connection on the server to allow clients to access local resources. You follow these steps. I share the wired connection with an interface called WG Server. Because the VPN server is behind the router, you configure port forwarding on the router. As I set up in the previous step, I use port 51820. I access my router and forward the ports as follows. Don't forget to set up a static IP address for the VPN server. I forward port 51820 to my static IP address. My VPN server is assigned the IP address 192.168.0.105. I have completed the WireGuard server configuration on the desktop. Now I will send the client's configuration file to the laptop. On my laptop I have WireGuard software installed. After obtaining the configuration file, I imported it into the WireGuard software. Now I establish a VPN connection to the server. As you can see, the VPN connection is successfully established. From there you can access internal resources via the internet. The public IP address changed after I successfully established the VPN connection. There is one more issue I want to guide you when you use dynamic public IP addresses. On the VPN server I install and set up a dynamic domain name to update the public IP address. There are many services for you to choose from. In this case I use a service called DynU, because it's free. You register an account and create a new domain name for free. On the VPN server you install software to update the public IP address. Thus the VPN connection will be established even if the public IP address changes. On the client computer, edit the configuration as follows. You replace the public IP address with the domain name. Once again, I set up a VPN connection using the domain name. VPN connection successful. Above are the steps to install and configure the WireGuard server on a Windows computer. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Good luck.